John and my dad acted like they didn't even know what I was talking about. I just have to accept the fact that I am an outsider in my own family.
Honey, that's not true.
Andy, the only proof I exist is a picture of my arm. I mean, even Bigfoot has pictures of his whole body.
You know that's just a guy in a furry suit.
Don't do this to me tonight, Andy. I am on edge.
Yeah, well, I'm on edge, too. Our daughter still isn't going to college. She won't even take the SATs. And me freaking out just made Kate dig her heels in even more. I think I really screwed this up.
You want me to talk to her?
No, thanks. I started this, and I'm gonna finish it.
Okay. Well, just know that I'm here for you. Hmm? Come here.
You're sweet.
Get off me! They're taking my boat again! Ha! I gotcha! Lowell?
You caught me.
Inside. I don't even know what to say. We were together all day trying to figure out who took my boat.
I know, it was so fun. Apart from the crippling guilt.
Then what were you thinking?
I've just been so lonely.
Then buy your own boat.
No, please, listen. Last week, I met this amazing woman who was into boats. So to make her like me, I told her I had a boat. Then last night, I invited her over to see my boat, at which point I needed a boat. I'm not proud of what I did, but I was desperate.
And to think I almost wore matching hats with you.
I'm so sorry.
Are you? If you're so sorry, then why are you here trying to steal it again?
Because tonight she surprised me with a booty call. I knew I couldn't get the booty without the boat, so I told her I loaned it to you.
You saw how upset I was about my dad and my brother, and you still didn't say anything. You know what that is, Lowell? That is unforgivable.
Lowell? I'm getting lonely out here.
Thanks for letting me borrow your boat.